Hi, I'm Xavier Bizoux, and today I will talk about the Go programming language. I'm often writing Python code, and I thought it might be a good idea to look at Go. In this video, I will introduce you to Go and show you how you can call the SAS Viya REST APIs using that language. Go is an open source language that was developed by a team at Google. Its fathers are Robert Grismer, who worked on Google's V8 JavaScript engine, Rob Pike, who worked at Bell Labs as a member of the Unix team, and Ken Thompson, who also worked at Bell Labs, where he designed the original Unix and invented the B language, which is the predecessor of C. Go is statically typed, which means that as a developer, you have to assign a type to each variable, function or module, which is not the case for Python, who guesses the variable types. Talking about the differences with Python, Go is a compiled language, while Python is interpreted. This means the program that you write needs to be compiled before execution. I already hear some of you saying, does that mean that I will have to type multiple comments before seeing my results? Don't worry, Go comes with a command line tool that takes care of compiling and running the code for you. But it means that unlike Python, that needs to be interpreted for each execution, Go compiles the code once and then executes it whenever needed. This is a clear advantage in terms of performance. Okay, we are not really here to compare the two languages and to say which one is the best. There are plenty of articles on the web doing that for you. When it comes to writing code, the syntax is similar to the one of C. If you are familiar to C, you might scratch your head and think, does that mean I need to handle the memory allocation? Don't worry, the syntax is similar to C, but Go comes with memory safety and garbage collection. It means that the language will handle the memory for you, which is a good point. Another good point for Go is that the language has been implemented with concurrency in mind from the beginning. Do you remember at the beginning of this slide, I was mentioning that Robert Grismer, one of the Go's father, worked on the V8 JavaScript engine. And guess what? He came with this asynchronous concept from JavaScript. Building the development environment, as a preparation for this workshop or for this video, I have installed Go on my machine, following the instruction on the project webpage. I've installed Visual Studio Code, which is an editor that you can use for many languages. If you prefer to use another editor, you can. Any text editor like Notepad, Notepad++, or any IDE will do the job. On the SAS side, I will be working on SAS Viya 2010.20.1 release, but everything you will see in this video works similarly on SAS Viya 3.5. There is one step that should be achieved on your SAS environment before you can make REST API calls. You should define a client application on your environment. You can therefore follow the instruction on the developer.sas.com website. As soon as you have everything installed and configured, you are ready to go. If you are familiar with tutorials on the web, the first code you often write is an hello world program. As you might guess, it will be the first Go code that you will see. Everything in Go is included in a package. In this case, we name it main. All the programs need to have the main function. That function is used as a starting point for your application. If you have a simple application like this one, you only have one function. But if you are building more advanced applications, you will have more functions and more modules, and those should be somehow linked to the main function. An example of a module is the FMT module that is imported here to print the text to the command line when executing the code. As you can see in the main function, I create a variable of type string with text as a variable name and assign it the word string to it. As Go is statically typed, all the variables should have a type, But as you will see later, it can also inherit the type from another variable, which is on the right hand side of the assignment operator. The next line is the FMT printf, where FMT is the package we imported and printf is a function that prints a formatted text to the command line. The person V is a placeholder for the value that is passed a second parameter to the function. As you might have noticed, Go doesn't use end-of-line separator like a semicolon in other language. This is pretty similar to Python. The biggest difference with Python in terms of syntax is that code blocks are defined using indentation in Python, while here in Go, we are using curly braces like in JavaScript, for example. You can type the code in your editor, save the file as hello.go on your machine, and when done, open a terminal or a DOS prompt, depending on your operating system, navigate to the location where you saved the file, and execute the go run command, followed by the name of the file containing the code. In the terminal, you should now see the hello world message. It means that you have written your first Go program. Now we will do a small demonstration using the SAS Viya REST APIs and the Go language. For that, I will move to Visual Studio Code. For this project, I've created different folders. A core folder, which contains the core functions for the application. A folder called folders, which will group all the functions related to the folder REST API. A samples folder, which contains the code that will be executed by the end user. Let's start with the core folder. It contains two files, call REST and get token. The call REST is part of the core package and import the following packages or modules. And then we have a function definition for the call REST. As you can see, the function definition, we are giving it a name. The function requires parameter, and we define the different parameters with their type. And we finally return a value, and in this case, it will be a byte array. Within the function, we are taking care of some security checks. We are using the parameters to define an HTTP request and to execute it. And finally, we handle the result and return the byte array. As you might have noticed, we have here a defer statement. Using the defer, you indicate that the function that is closing the response body should be done asynchronously. As a result, the HTTP request will have the time to execute and return a response. The same way you would do this with promises in JavaScript. We have another function in the core package. This is the get token. That function will connect to the SAS Viya server and return an access token that will be used to perform other requests. This function uses the call REST function that we have just seen. In this file, we see that Go can create structures. Structures are a bit like objects in other languages. In this case, we are defining structures to map information that the REST API will send in JSON format to a usable variable in Go. We have two structures, a auth info and a token. As you can see in the function definition here, it's using the auth info structure that we have defined. We can consider it as a method for the auth info structure. This means that it is bound to the structure and can only be used combined with that structure. The function requires a URL parameter and will return a token structure that is defined above. The function will define the information for the call REST function. The information are coming from the structure that the function is bound to and the parameters. The call to the REST API is then executed, and the JSON result is then parsed and the token structure is returned. In this code, we have two different ways to assign and define variables. As you can see, we are using the colon equal operator, which uses a type from the variable on the right hand side and assigns it to the variable created on the left hand side. We can also create a variable using the var statement as for the token variable. And in this case, we specify var, we give it a name, and we define the type of variable it is. It's now time to see the get folders. So the get folders is the function that will be executed to get folder information. We are importing some specific packages again, and we are pointing also to the core package that we have defined with the two functions in it. We then define some structures. The structures will map the JSON elements for a folder list that will be retrieved from the SAS Viya REST API. And as you can see, the folder list contains some items, and those items are of type folder, and some others are of type links. We'll define the structures for them, so a folder structure and also a link struct. Now that we have all our functions or our structures defined, we will see the getFolder function. And in this case, the getFolder function requires a URL as a parameter, also a token that we can generate using the getToken function, and also some parameters to filter in our REST API call. The function is pretty similar to the getToken function, except that we are passing an access token to the header. Now that we have all those functions defined, it's time to wrap them all within some code. We will go to the samples directory where we have the get folders program. This program defines the main package and the main function. We have to import the packages that will be used. In this case, we are also importing the core and the folders that we have defined earlier. We define some variables. These variables are used to store the information that should be passed by the user through the command line when using the application. The flag package takes care of reading the input and assigning the information to the correct variables. In this case, we are using pointers to the defined variables. Using the information retrieved from the command line, we are defining an OAuth info object, and the other variables are also created. As you can see here, we are calling the AI get token. So from the OAuth info, we are using the get token, using the base URL, it will return a token. Then we specify the query. We add some query parameters, some search, and then we call the get folders from the folders package. We specify the base URL that we want to call, the token, and the query parameters. When done, the FL object structure will be created, and we will run through it and print a list of folders with their ID, the name, and the number of members. When you call this function or program, you will call the get folders, your user, you pass it minus U, minus P for the password, the URL to the server, then the application secret name and secret limits if you want to have only two return objects, and then finally the search information. I will now execute the code. So for that, I will open a terminal. I will go to the samples folder, then go run, get folders. I need to specify the user, get demo 123. I need to specify a password. I need to specify the host name where my SAS Viya is installed. I need to specify the client application that I have defined earlier. I need to specify the secret. Then I will specify an option to limit the number of rows that is returned. And I will also add a search for gate demo. When done, I press enter. And it returns a list of ID, the name of the folders, and the number of members. This is what I was expecting. So now that I'm fine with the code, I will go build. It will build the code. And as you see here, it's creating a binary code or a compiled version. So that means that now, if I want to execute the same command as before, I don't need to use the go anymore, nor go run. I just type this, and it will give me the same result. So if you want to get additional information, you can have a look at the Go project website, golang.org, or the SAS developer website, developer.sas.com/api/rest. You can find the information at the bottom of this video. Thank you for watching, and check back with Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.